Last national referendum in Zambia was a while ago. It was in 1967. So this would be the first time the Zambian Electoral Commission manages an election along with a referendum since it has been established in 1966. Basically, the referendum is to allow Zambians to choose whether or not the coming parliament can amend part three of the country's constitution. Part three of the country's constitution deals with individual civic and political rights, and this is part of completing the constitution-making process. The referendum vote is very important because, as we know, a Bill of Rights enshrines and protects certain individual rights that the government cannot infringe on. Of course, there is a lot of confusion and concerns about what people are really voting for in the referendum. There's also concerns about the implications of the referendum vote to future democratic processes. Another important change in these elections is, as I have already mentioned, the electoral legislation for the presidential race. There is now a 50% plus one threshold for winning the presidential vote. Before, the presidential vote was elected in a single round using a first past the post electoral model. Now, there would be a rerun in 37 days if there is no outright winner, basically if nobody meets the 50 plus one threshold. The new electoral legislation has also introduced the idea of presidential running mates who then become the vice presidents. Before, the vice presidents were appointed after elections, and as we are all aware in Zambian politics, the rules of succession were very unclear. Now, under the new electoral model, vice presidents can directly assume office if the president, the presidential seat is vacant. Now to the management of the elections themselves. This is also very controversial in the context of Zambian elections. The perceived partiality of the Electoral Commission. There is now a new chair of the Electoral Commission of Zambia. The chair was appointed in 2014 by President Edgar Lungu, who is the incumbent. The former chair was, as I said, recently appointed. And another new appointment is the appointment of the Chief Justice. The Chief Justice and the Chair of the Electoral Commission are from Lungu's region. This is already causing some friction because in Zambia, judiciary bodies adjudicate election-related grievances. Petitions for the presidential elections this time also go to the Constitutional Court. This is a new court. It was established in January this year. The deputy of the Constitutional Court is a well-known judge in Zambian politics, Judge Mungeni Mulenga. Judge Mungeni Mulenga ruled in favor of President Lungu in 2014 when fellow members from his party, the Patriotic Front, challenged his candidature for the presidency. The other issue which may compromise or affect the perceived neutrality of the Constitutional Court in adjudicating election-related grievances is that the judge is related to the president through marriage. It is also very important to know that the rulings from the Constitutional Court of Zambia in terms of the petitions that have been submitted cannot be appealed. So, what are the real stakes in these elections, and why do we say the stakes are high? Firstly, while nine political parties are contesting the presidential vote, the race is essentially a very tight one between incumbent President Edgar Lungu of the ruling Patriotic Front and Hakainde Hichilema from the main opposition, which is the United Party for National Development, UPND. So these are the four runners. Lungu beat Hichilema with less than 2% of the vote in the last presidential by-election, and none of them got more than 50% of the vote. And it's very important to understand why this is important, because no party in the history of the Zambian elections has amassed an outright win in the last four national polls. Therefore, a rerun in terms of the presidential race is very likely. In the event of a rerun, out of the nine parties that are contesting the presidential race, I confidently can say seven out of these nine parties are affiliated with the Patriotic Front. And they may rally behind Lungu in the event of a rerun. So this essentially is what can be termed as a do or die election for the Patriotic Front and also for the UPND. And the outcome, in my view, can potentially end or influence the path of their political careers. For the Patriotic Front, of course, there is a lot of pressure for the president to win. He has the power of the incumbency. But also, Lungu has also thus far served a year. And he now is being tested on the basis of his own legacy within this 1 year that he has served. On the other hand, Hichilema is running for the fifth time, the presidential race. He's also running at a time when the UPND is at its strongest, because the UPND is now backed by very influential members from the Patriotic Front who actually defected from the PF because of contention over Lungu's presidential candidacy in 2015. A loss on either side has dire consequences for their political longevity and the strength of the party. Lastly, let's not forget what these elections are really about. Elections are supposed to be about the needs of the electorate. Currently, Zambia is facing its worst economic crisis in more than 10 years. The cost of living is high. People can't afford the very basics. And a staggering 60% of the population of Zambia live below the poverty belt. Definitely, bread and butter issues will affect the voting patterns. What are the flashpoints or things to look out for? Well, there is an upsurge of localized political violence. It will be very interesting to see how the final days of the campaigning are managed and whether there will be more political violence just before the poll tomorrow. Today, there is a big campaign that has been organized by the UPND that has been reportedly denied by the police on the grounds that the permission has not been granted. Whether this will lead to clashes or concerns that there has been partiality on the side of the police, and whether this will be used by the opposition to contest the outcome remains to be seen. There is also a worry about the turnout of the voters in these elections. While the numbers are high in terms of registration, there's been low voter turnout in the past three polls. For instance, in 2015, we saw 30%, 32% of the voter turnout, and the previous election was at 53, and then the 2008 elections was at 45. Turnout is important because it really challenges the credibility of the outcome and the popular consensus within which that candidate has been elected. Another flashpoint is about the tallying process. When the elections are done, it will be time for telling the results and then obviously announcing them. The last elections, we saw that there were delays in counting and the telling process took very long. In fact, the Zambian Electoral Commission took 4 days to announce the election and the election result. And this really aggravates tensions in a political landscape that is already hotly contested. Another flashpoint will be the outcome of the national referendum and also the national vote. The contention around the national referendum and the way that it is being managed may be used as well as a grievance in these polls by especially the opposition, who have been campaigning for a no vote with the referendum. The referendum has basically been politicized, and there are fears that the referendum itself would be used to rig the election, because the qualification for who votes for the referendum is very different from the qualification of who votes for the national poll. The national poll is going to be using the electoral register, while the referendum is going to allow anybody who's eligible to vote, but not on the voter's roll, to be able to cast their ballot. Lastly, there will be worries or contentions around the manner in which electoral petitions are handled by the Constitutional Court. The petitions and challenges are supposed to be filed in the Constitutional Court within 7 days of the elections. They're supposed to be heard within 14, and an outcome of these petitions is supposed to be decided within 30 days. The perceived partiality of the courts is very worrying right now, and the outcome of these petitions is definitely going to be a cause of concerns once the elections are finalized. So that is the long and short of the politics and the dynamics that characterize the Zambian elections. The polls will go ahead tomorrow, and it's going to be a very tight race, as I said, between the incumbent and the leading opposition party, the UPND. The UPND has already come into these elections with a message that the elections are likely to be rigged, and then encouraging their supporters to believe that there is also an uneven playing field for the opposition. So the race is very tight. It is also very tense. The main objection is that the timing is off, that there has not been sufficient time on the part of the Zambian Electoral Commission to embark on educating Zambians on exactly what they're voting for. Basically, the issue around the referendum question. Opposition parties feel that Zambians do not know what they're voting for, and that the no and yes vote is very misleading in the manner in which that the question has been posed to Zambians. Basically, that there's not been enough civic and voter education to allow the vote to take place at this current time. The opposition is also saying that the referendum should have been run separately, and it should because it's a constitutional matter that needs more debate nationally. And so these are the main contentions that they're raising. And then thirdly, the issue of rigging. The opposition contends that because the referendum and the elections use different qualification for voting, the numbers may be manipulated in the final instance. We can use some of the signals from the past to determine how tight the race may be. The last election saw a difference of only 2% in terms of the margin of victory between the UPND and the PF. So we would say that the likelihood of an outright win, somebody getting 50+1% from the first round, is very, very low. I predict, in the event that there is no outright win, A second round between Lungu and the Patriotic, between Lungu, who comes from the Patriotic Front, and Hikilema from the UPND. In the event of that rerun, I see a lot of support from the other parties going to the Patriotic Front. So in that likelihood, the PF is likely to get the presidential victory. In Zambia, we have what we call pasta politicians. You know, we have politicians that actually are using the religious platform to advocate for their causes. We also see President Lungu using the platform of the Catholic churches to popularize his message. So definitely, this is a political strategy that is being employed by the political parties. And this will definitely sway the voting population towards certain political choices. The risks are high. If between January and July, you have more than 50 incidences of political violence reported in the build-up to the elections, it is very, very worrying. And one of the issues also that is aggravating the situation is the way that political violence is being handled by the Zambian police. The Zambian police is perceived to be very partisan. And in instances like this, we've also seen it in South Africa, where the police is seen to not be impartial. You already have a psychological kind of clash between voters and the security forces. So the risk of violence is very high, also because the electoral pledges of peace and the all the calls and appeals for peace are not being respected by all the political parties, I would say. The political violence is coming from both sides. That is very important to highlight. It is coming both from the PF and the UPND in particular. And it really speaks about a politics that is very unhealthy, the relationship between the opposition and the government. It's just a very unhealthy political relationship. It's very antagonistic. And anything that happens is dealt with in a very antagonistic fashion. So the risk of political violence is high. It's also high in certain provinces, especially in Lusaka and the Copper Belt, where the incidences of election-related violence has been very, very high. I would like to hope so, because we have seen a change of parties before in 2011, where Banda of the Movement for Multi-Party Democracy conceded a defeat peacefully. So this is a scenario that one should highly encourage, that the PF, in the event that they are defeated, would step down in a peaceful way. And this will also be set a very good example in terms of the politics that they have been preaching of peaceful political participation and political tolerance in Zambian politics. Zambia normally is a very peaceful country, but things tend to get out of hand during elections because of a lack of political tolerance between parties and a fight for power.